Hello, hello. Right, let's get out of here. Load. And the problem was, the goods that they wanted to go in the back hadn't arrived. Well, half of them had. And then they got the goods and they'd all collapsed on the pallet, so they had to restack it on the pallet.
At the end of the road, turn right, 3102 Beamersbrook Road.
Came in. Where did I come in here? Lyneham, yeah.
Turn right.
Go, go, go. Go! Come on! Fucking hell. Oh. In like that. Thank you. Made it a day, letting a big hairy trucker come out. I don't think it's particularly heavy. Doesn't feel heavy. There's a few ton on board, but I don't think there's any more than about 10, 12 ton in loaded in, which puts me about.
Take the first exit, 3102 Oxford Road.
28, 29 tonne, something on it. Under 30 anyway.
Go left on the roundabout and take the first exit.
There you go. Signalling one way, going another. Son.
Follow a 3102 for 4 miles.
Oh, look at that big motorbike. What's that made out of? Scaffold. Wow. Didn't see that on the way in. Around. The lads in that place, they were good as gold actually. Really nice, friendly bunch. It makes such a difference, you know. Yeah, shut up. Let's get past him. Turn that off, it would be beeping all the time going along here. You can't help but go over the roads. I don't remember coming back here, but I remember that pub, Duke Hotel. Everything's done by pubs, isn't it? If you're a bit old-fashioned like yourself. So what are the youngsters going to do? Because they don't go to the pubs, how are they going to remember where they're going? I remember everything by what pub I've driven by. Or in some cases, what pubs I've been into. On is this my last job of the day, like going to the docks and finishing, or are they gonna go, oh, we just got one to go up to Lutterworth or Litchfield would be my betting. Wouldn't surprise me. Acre. It's a good West Country name. I deliver goat acre. I've got a goat, an acre. There's bridges around here somewhere, aren't they? I'm going to go to FDN in case it's here. That's not here. But it's close by. Clanking. New Zealand. Somewhere called New Zealand there. You've got to thread these, thread your way through these like calming bollards, haven't you? The bollards that they put in the road there and the curbs. So, Lyneham to my left. Don't know what you'll see from this direction. Based here, big Greenie contingent. I don't think they used to be.
Exit.
Good to go. Mallard.
After 900 feet, cross the roundabout and take the second exit, 3102, the green. Cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
Use all the space. That's a low canopy.
Follow a 3102, the green, for 3.5 miles.
I think these bridges are around here somewhere. She's all right on the hills. So I don't think there's a great deal of weight in the back. Ah, that is why that bale is there, because it's got pumpkin faces on it. Sort myself out with a drink before. That was the last dregs of my coffee. Wootton and Tottenham Wick. There's a butcher's there. Might go to the butcher's on Saturday and buy some nice meat. Maybe a couple of big thick pork chops. I might go and buy an air fryer, actually. Warning. Got a warning light come up. Saying I was about to crash into something. I forget I'm in Wiltshire at the moment. God, have they cut the hedges back a little bit now? And these bridges are a lot further towards Royal Wootton Batten, Bassett, than I thought. Whilst waiting, I had a bowl of granola and a mint club biscuit. Rock and roll, eh? Living life on the edge, cold is bloody bumpy. happened with Blaine? Where Blaine is? This is where the bridges are. There's two of us coming through. And he's on L plates. Oh, here we go. They must have seen him coming through. Must have seen him coming. Yet they still barge their way on through, don't they? Unbelievable. Sensible man there. The other two weren't. Well, I didn't see if that was an Arctic or a rigid. What's he in? I think he's in an Arctic, I think. Played of bringing him through here. Keep going, my son, keep going, and stop. Power! Myself a bit of room here to see what this boy's doing, so I don't get stuck covering a junction or something ridiculous. Those old buildings, beautiful, aren't they? Pay it back a bit. Just about tuck in there. Beautiful. They put the buildings up like that because that was the old corn stores and the market. So they put them up there so all the corn would come in, go out there, and the rats wouldn't be able to get to them, I think. If my understanding of some medieval buildings is correct, not being an expert or anything. The old bank antiques. There we go. See what we got going on here. Truck parked. Go on, my son, you got plenty of room. On you go. Oh, is there somebody stuck out? Yeah, there is, yeah. Oh, yeah, that van stuck out, isn't he? Well, let's try not to get ourselves tangled up in it. Because that wouldn't look good.
After 600 feet, cross the roundabout and take the second exit, 3102 High Street.
He's smiling. It's a bit tight, but oh, now we got lights. That's there probably was a whole load of pubs along here, but I haven't seen many. Perhaps I missed them.
Cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
Oh, the red line.
1102 High Street.
What's everyone doing here? Alright, okay. Yeah. This was just a reverse of the way I came in this morning. You go by old Sally's pussy in a minute.
After 900 feet, go right on the roundabout and take the third exit, 3102. Swindon Road. Go right on the roundabout and take the third exit.
There's the Royal. Churchill's.
After a quarter of a mile, cross the roundabout and take the first exit, 3102 Swindon Road. Cross the roundabout and take the first exit.
Well, that was a baptism of fire going through Wootton Bassett for him, wasn't it? Cool, blimey. But he's glad to be through there. No, you stay in there. Right. Gravel all over the road. Someone's shedding loads. Trouble is, I could pop those stones all over the place. Flick them up into someone's windshield. Can't really do a lot about it. Sally's pussies. Well, she had more than one. Clever, cool. What's so special about her pussy then? Tasty portions, it said at the bottom. I bet. Oh. I bet there's been loads of people through there. It must be like a wizard's sleeve.
exit M4 towards London.
M4 east. That'll be this one here then. Let's try and get into the right lane, eh? I think we've managed it.
Go right on the roundabout.
Actually, I don't think we have after all of that. I think I need to be in that right-hand lane. Oh, well. There's nothing to me right. The roads and lanes are narrow as well, look. God, Bennett.
Take the exit.
They don't really put you into the correct lanes here. Now he's going to outgun me, I reckon. Unless the lights change. I can gun it. Lights are about to change. He's going. He's one step ahead. Oh, he's got some dust coming off of that, look. Hello. Right. That's my loaded box off. I'm clear. Fucking hell. I'm clear of the docks. All we've got to contend with now is the roadworks. And then it's the roadworks, and then going into Elder Point to get a loaded box. And I'm not convinced they've given me the right reference number to get the loaded box, to get an empty box out. Be home tonight, which is good. Which is very nice, actually. I've eaten everything that I need to eat. Well, everything I've got. Well, I've got a banana left. I've got some bananas left. I'll be chomping into them in a minute. So as you saw, it's about a saddler's cross to go to the railhead from the docks. So once I've done this, straight back to the yard, refuel, park up, go home. Straight to two now, but I don't reckon I'll be out of it. I just don't know. Straight to two. Let's see what actual time it is. By the time we're clear of this fuckwittery. Boxes in there now. I'm not entirely sure what they're doing in there. Loaded box done and dusted. So I'm gonna get this empty. Oh, they put cones all down here now, look. Stop people parking. It's a green. Unusual. And traffic looks like it's flowing. Wow, wow. Didn't expect this. Flowing-ish. This lane looks like it's moving. I've got two options here. Go over the flyover or under it. I'm skipping a load of traffic. Getting into this lane nice and early. So it all goes down to one lane here. And I don't know whether it's, I think it might actually be quicker to have stayed in the far left hand lane and gone through the traffic lights to, I think it is. Go through the traffic lights to pop up the other side of the roundabout. All this is flowing through, look. Yeah, I'd have been through by now. Okay, we know for future. Right, if I leave a gap, I'm asking you to go in, aren't I? If you choose not to go in, don't expect me to leave another gap. There you go. So I've got to stretch the container out. Stretch the container out. I have to stretch the trailer out when I get to this place. And that's what the pin's about. When I come out of this place that I'm going to, I've got to go back down this road and back around that roundabout again. Take as long as I thought it was going to take. down at Ealing Wharf. Whole bit of the docks. Rubbish bin gone over. This far, so far. I have queued all the way out here before. It's a bit bumpy in places, like there. Looking good. Oh my word. A good view of the docks on the other side of the water here. Oh, if you can handle the bumps. So I'm just going to stretch the trailer, so I'll speak to you all in a bit. And there you get a good view of the docks from the other side of the water. That's where I've just been, where those two shipping containers are. You can just see all the straddlers whizzing about over there. And I've come across the water, gone around over the top, over the river. I'm on the south side now, and looking across to where the dock, where the boats are. One big boat, one little boat. There isn't a boat down the end. And I'm picking up a empty box from in here, hopefully. Yeah. Find out in a minute. Moving. So yeah, you get a bit quite picturesque. I always come this side, even if it's even if it's busy, just so I get a better view. Right, speak to you later. Thank you. said, follow the lorry in front. So I'm following the lorry in front. So that means pins don't bump, drop out. Turn right, and I'll meet you in the middle. Oh. Didn't know there was a little estuary down in there. Picking up a Hapag Lloyd box, I believe. It looks like he's got about as much idea as I have. Oh, no. I don't know if he's going to the right place or not. He's just waiting there. So we're just having a see. All you can see is boxes. I'm not quite sure what's going on, so we're just sort of doing a bit of hurry up and waiting. Let's move a bit further forward so I can see what this mate is doing. Don't know where he's going to get my Hapag Lloyd box from. See the box being loaded on. In for the kill for another one. Should be my one. Further up. Shout out to him there. Just want to check to make sure it's a Hapag Lloyd book. Hapag. Oh, I don't know, even know if it is a Hapag Lloyd. Whatever box it is, that's the box that's going on. Well, it's not that blue one that he just went by. It's a CMA box, different shipping line. Yeah, beat the yawn when I'm in the right place, like that. And you've just got to position the box onto the back of the truck, under the four pins. Swaying around a bit. Nice and gentle-ish. Right, it's clear. Ready to go. Right. I know, but just going up here. Whoa, 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 whoa. Thank you. not telepathic, mate. Fuck you know. Still recording. Well, that was quicker than I thought. 24 minutes. Oh, fucking shut up. Now I just got to negotiate the roadworks again. Right, well I'm all ready for Monday morning now. And I've got to be in, I think I've been to this place before. Witness. Vaguely, the company name rings a bell? I don't know. It's Witness anyway. Up north like. I don't have to be out there until 11:30, which is a decent time. Got a few haulage companies down here. Olivia. So there's a lot of, like I said, there's a lot of haulage companies down in there. Maybe we've got to loop round again. Holding. He's close with his headboard. No hope of getting out. The truck going in, let me out, give me the nod that he was turning. So I'm going back round the roundabout, hopefully it won't be too bad. Could be home for 4 o'clock, which would be nice. Should be back in the yard by 2:45 at the absolute latest. So yeah, not too bad at all actually, then, is it? I had a 1 o'clock on the docks, wasn't it? Just after one. And it's 2:20 now, so yeah, I was alright. All things considering. Yeah, not too bad at all. Right, so all I've got to do is a quick hoover up, clear my shit up. Get me bags into the car, go home. Trying to work out where this traffic's going. It's just about to plumb in. Oh, next time I stop. So Tesla's taking up 2 lanes now. Well done. Just stay in the lane you're in, mate, you know? There you go, now back into the original lane. Nope, he's staying in both lanes. He's going right in the middle. I can't really get round there, so I'm just going to stop here. Otherwise I'll totally snarl things up. Can I get in there? Why don't you go and get in there? Move, I can go. Come on, just a little bit further. Blow me on me, didn't think that that was a necessity. I'm clear. Hey. Fair old way away, I think. It's witness. The handbrake went off, wasn't it? Just realised there's a tent there, isn't it? Pop up tent.
You arrive at your destination at 1959.
Hmm, well, 233 miles away. Someone's gonna have to let me in. You ain't gonna like it, are you? Can I reach my banana? Just. Oh, there's four of them. Five even. I'm not gonna get through five bananas. And then they're gonna be all manky by Monday. Really getting anywhere, are we? Oh, I cut the foot. So anyway, this is going to bore you to death. I'm just saying traffic.
Traffic on M3 E05.
No
traffic
shit.
Jam ahead. Is between Hotley Link and Eastern Lane. 2 minutes delay.
There's a traffic jam here, my love. Anyway, all I've got to do is get through this next set of lights, and I'm home and dry. So have a good weekend. I shall speak to you all on Monday, no doubt. Cheers.